So here's the answer. We're going to define a procedure. So we use the def followed by the name. We'll use the name square followed by the left paren. And now we need to decide what the parameters are. And remember, when we define procedures, we should always be thinking about what the inputs are and what the outputs are. In this case, the input is one number. We see in our example, it was the number 5. We can give that any name we want. N is usually a good name for a number, so we'll use N. And then we have the colon. And now we're ready to define the body of square. What we want square to compute is the square of the number, so we want to multiply N by N, and that's the output. So we can do everything with one statement. It's going to be a return statement, where the expression that we're returning is N times N. We want to get the value of N squared, and that's what we return. So here's how that looks in the interpreter. We're defining square, our body returns n times n, and we're going to print the result of square 5. We get 25. We can use a variable. Let's say x has the value 37. We can print the result of square x. We get a bigger number. That's 37 times 37. And we could also do this. Let's say we assign y the result of square x, and then let's print the result of squaring y. So that will give us 37 squared, and then we're going to square it again. That gets quite a large number. 1.8 million or so. We could do those compositions without variables. So we could do this directly. We could print the square of the square of x. So we're calling square twice here. The first time we're passing in 37. Then we're getting the output of that. And then we're passing it into square again. This is called procedure composition. This is the way most programs are written, that we're going to write little procedures. Each procedure is going to take some inputs and produce some output. But then we're going to use the outputs that we get the first time we use a procedure as the inputs to the next procedure. In this case, we only have one procedure defined, so I've used square twice. When we run this, we see the value of 37 squared, which is quite a big number. We'll see lots more examples of how we can compose procedures using the outputs of one procedure as the inputs to the next procedure to get lots more interesting things done. And you'll write some procedures that do that yourself pretty soon.